So dear students, today we are going to learn something about MVP, that is method of variation of parameters. And to explain that, I have taken the first classwork example from our notes. So d square minus 1 y is equal to cos of e raised to minus x plus e raised to minus x into sine of e raised to minus x. For finding out yc, as usual, we take d square minus 1 equal to 0, that is d is equal to plus or minus 1. Thus, yc is equal to c1 e raised to x plus c2 e raised to minus x. Now, all the while till today, we used to find yp by using the formula yp is equal to 1 upon f of d acting on capital X, where this entire thing is basically taken as capital X. But now, in the method of variation of parameters, we assume YP based on YC. Now, if your YC is C1 e raised to X plus C2 e raised to minus X, we assume YP as U into Y1 plus V into Y2, where y1 is nothing but this e raised to x and y2 is nothing but this e raised to minus x. That means the only thing that is left for us to find out is this u and v. Now let us see how to find that u and v. Before finding u and v, we need to find something which is called as w. Okay? Now how to find this w? W is nothing but it is the determinant of y1, y2, y1 dash, y2 dash. That means it is nothing but e raised to x, e raised to minus x, and then e raised to x ka derivative is e raised to minus x ka derivative is minus e raised to minus x. When you multiply this, you are going to get minus 1 minus 1, that is equal to minus 2. So this is how you are going to get W. Now how this W is going to be useful in finding this U and V, let us see. U is given by the formula minus integration of Y to X upon W dx. So that will be equal to minus of integration Y to. If you look at the question, y2 was taken instead of e raised to minus x. So y2 ki jagah pe I substitute e raised to minus x. Capital X is nothing but cos of e raised to minus x plus e raised to minus x sine of e raised to minus x upon w we just found out. W is nothing but minus 2 dx. Now let us see how to solve this integration. So ye minus 2 hai, isko main bahar le leta hu, to ye ban jayega 1 upon 2. And now you have integration of e raised to minus x into cos of e raised to minus x plus e raised to minus x sine of e raised to minus x. Now first of all, I didn't like this angle at all, e raised to minus x. So I decide that I'll put e raised to minus x as t. Therefore, minus e raised to minus x dx will become equal to dt. Therefore, your integration will be t into cos t plus t into sin t. I'm sorry, this t need not be written over here because this e raised to minus x into dx, okay, into dx can be collectively written as minus dt. So this minus sign will come out now as minus 1 by 2 into cos t plus t sin t dt. So that will be minus 1 by 2. Integration of cos t will be sin t. And integration of t sin t will be t into minus cos t minus 1 into minus sin t. That's all. So it will become minus 1 by 2 into 2 sin t minus t cos t. Okay. This will be equal to minus 1 by 2 into 2 sin of e raised to minus x minus e raised to minus x cos of e raised to minus x. When you open the bracket, you will get minus of sin e raised to minus x plus e raised to minus x upon 2 cos of e raised to minus x. So this is the u that you are searching for. So let this be your equation number 2. Now, if we want to find out the value of v, okay, v is given by the formula v is equal to integration of y1 capital X upon w dx. Y1, if you remember, in our question, y1 was e raised to x and your capital X was cos of e raised to minus x plus e raised to minus x sin of e raised to minus x dx upon w was nothing but minus 2. If I take minus 1 by 2 out, I'll get e raised to x into cos of e raised to minus x plus e raised to minus x sin of e raised to minus x dx. Now, whenever you have the question of the type or integration of the type e raised to x into something plus something, the first thing that you should keep in mind is probably it is of the type e raised to x into f of x plus f dash of x. But let us verify this fact over here. If cos of e raised to minus x is f of x, then its derivative will be minus sine of e raised to minus x into derivative of e raised to minus x, which is minus of e raised to minus x. So yes, this is your f dash of x. So this answer will be e raised to x into f of x. So your answer is minus of e raised to x upon 2 cos of e raised to minus x. Now, this is your equation number 3. So now what we can do is, we can substitute 2 and 3 in equation number 1. So equation number 1, let me tell you, we had assumed yp as u into y1 plus v into y2. So u that we got was minus of sine e raised to minus x plus e raised to minus x upon 2 into cos of e raised to minus x. Ye hamara u tha. y1 jo hum logon ne assume kiya tha wo e raised to x tha. Plus v jo humko mila, that v was minus e raised to minus x upon 2 cos of e raised to minus x into y2 jo hum logon ne assume kiya tha wo e raised to minus x tha. So when you open the brackets, you will get minus e raised to x sin of e raised to minus x plus 1 by 2 into cos of e raised to minus x. When you multiply this with this, you will get 1 by 2 cos of e raised to minus x. And when you multiply these two, this is e raised to plus x. And when you multiply these two, you will get minus 1 by 2 e raised to minus x. And thus this and this will get cancelled. You will get minus e raised to x sine of e raised to minus x. The complete solution of the differential equation is y is equal to yc plus yp. That means y is equal to c1 e raised to x plus c2 e raised to minus x minus e raised to x sine of e raised to minus x.